Joining us now from Burlington, Vermont, Bernie Sanders campaign manager Jeff Weaver, who joins us again. Jeff, thank you for coming on.
My pleasure.
We were pretty surprised by Senator Sanders' statement on Nevada and his calling out what he thought was bad practices. Just tell people, what's the worst thing that happened on Saturday that really voters should know about around the country and care about?
Well, I mean, the way the convention started, I think if you watch the video online, you can see it. And this was confirmed by people like Senator Nina Turner, who was there in the room, who's a former senator from Ohio. When they tried to pass temporary rules to shut off debate in the event, they were asked for the yeas and nays, you know, a voice vote. People in the room pretty clearly said that the nays won it. At worst, it was indecisive, and yet the chair overruled them, said the ayes had it, and then proceeded, you know, to run the convention under these modified temporary rules, which were designed to sort of foreclose debate.
So what's the difference between the outcome that exists now and the outcome that you think would have existed had the thing been run, from your point of view, fairly?
Well, I'm not sure how the outcome would have been different, Mark, but I don't think that's really the issue. The issue is a huge segment of the Democratic Party going to be treated with fairness? And I don't think that happened in Nevada, based on everybody that I have talked to. You know, the Bernie Sanders has run in states all across this country, and by and large, state Democratic parties have been extremely fair and tried to be even-handed. And that just was not the experience in Nevada, either at the state level or, you know, if you look back at the Clark County Convention that happened recently, where they tried to depose against their own rules, their own credentials chair, and almost had her arrested because there was a perception that she was being too fair to the Sanders people. So there's been this is not just Saturday. It was a lot of events leading up to it. I think there was a lot of frustration. Obviously, our campaign condemns any suggestion of violence or threats, but clearly there has been a level of unfairness in Nevada that we have not seen in other states.
Jeff, this is Al Hunt here. Let me ask you, tell us about the Harry Reid, Bernie Sanders conversation.
Well, I don't really talk about people's conversations. I know they've had a couple of conversations. I think they're positive conversations. You know, they're friends. They've served with each other in the Senate for many, many years. I think there's a lot of mutual respect. But, I, you know, I'm not really going to get into...
Senator Reid clearly didn't anticipate what Senator Sanders said this afternoon. It was obvious in what Senator Reid said beforehand.
Right. Well, you know, what Senator Sanders said is he obviously condemns violence. He wants the people who support him to be treated fairly. There's 9 million people, over 9 million people in this country who have supported him. There certainly is resistance among some establishment players in the Democratic Party, whether they be in the Nevada State Party or certainly at the national, at the DNC, who, you know, are not as welcoming of all of these new people who have come into the process, all these young people, democratically aligned independents in many cases, who have come out and supported Senator Sanders' message to deal with a corrupt campaign finance system and a rigged economy. So, you know, there's some...
Do you include Brooklyn and the Clinton campaign in that criticism?
No, I mean, the Clinton campaign has not weighed in on this per se, but, you know, obviously I think people perceive themselves as operating in the interests of the Clinton campaign.
Jeff, given the success you've already had and are likely to have in the remaining contest, is it fair to say now that you're going to go to the convention with the posture of trying to do everything you can to win over superdelegates in Philadelphia, and so Philadelphia will be more about, or at least partially about, fighting still for the nomination rather than coming together behind Secretary Clinton and fighting Donald Trump? Is that fair to say?
Well, I think what is fair to say is whoever comes out of the convention as the nominee, I think will come out with a united party that is prepared to take on Trump and the Republicans. I think that is certainly fair to say. You know, this process has a long way to go, and we will see how the final states go. You know, if the delegate margin can be narrowed substantially, I think that there certainly will be an appeal to superdelegates. I think the senator has said that himself. But there are other issues as well at the convention that have to be dealt with, including the platform and including looking for ways to open up the nominating process and to deal with, you know, many of the things that we've seen over the course of the year in the various states that are often, you know, not a result of malice, but just sort of institutional impediments to people being able to fully participate
in
the democratic process.
I'm not trying to instigate a fight here, but it just seems to me you all have had enough success, no matter what happens tonight, even almost no matter what happens in June, that your posture seems to be, and I'm just trying to confirm that the convention is about having disputes about who the nominee is, going to be, who the superdelegates should vote for, what should be in the platform, should the rules of how Democrats nominate their candidates in the future, that's for you all, that's what Philadelphia is about, more than uniting in the beginning of the convention behind Hillary Clinton. Is that fair to say?
Well, I think at this point that's exactly right. I mean, the convention is about nominating the candidate of the Democratic Party for President of the United States. That's the whole point of the convention.
Right. So you go into that. You're not looking forward to showing up in Philadelphia if Hillary Clinton seems anointed by the media. You're not looking forward to showing up in Philadelphia from day one and saying, let's figure out when Senator Sanders is going to give his big speech endorsing her. Is that?
Well, I mean, let's be clear. The media anointed Secretary Clinton the day that Senator Sanders announced his candidacy. I mean, this has always been an uphill fight, and he has said repeatedly he is going all the way to the convention. So you don't need to hear it from me. He said it repeatedly. I mean,
Jeff, give us one or two of the most important platform planks for the Sanders campaign.
Well, I think there are many of the issues that he's been talking about. You know, a universal health care through a single payer system, $15 minimum wage, free tuition at public colleges and universities, dealing with a broken trade policy. I mean, I could go on, but you know, those are the sort of dealing with climate change.
Okay, Jeff.
That's
Weaver.
A big list.
Jeff, last question. Got to be a quick one.
Sure. Of course.
What adjective would you use to describe the mood in your headquarters right now?
I think determined, I think, would be the adjective I would use.